with a sister last week. Me and her were sitting down and talking, and she said, if I can get up and go to work every day, I should be able to go into the house of God and work and labor and do that. Now, and I have to let her understand, there's a difference between serving the world and serving God. There's a major difference, because there is spiritual opposition that comes against a believer, amen? There is spiritual opposition. There is a different level of suffering. Yeah, you may have to deal with your boss on the job, but guess what you get at the end of the day? You get a paycheck, amen? And as long as you keep that in mind when you're working for the world, you can put up with a lot, amen? Because in the back of your head, you're saying, guess what? There is a paycheck involved, amen? I get something tangible placed in my hand. If somebody's placing, you can say whatever you want, but you just make sure it's in my hand, amen? At the end of the day, see, that's the natural. Serving the world is natural. Serving the world, at the end of the day, whatever you put me through, you better pay me. Serving God is different. Because the Bible says the weapons of our warfare are not carnal, but they're mighty through God for the pulling down of strongholds. Why do you need spiritual weapons in the kingdom of God? Because when you're serving God, there is going to be some suffering, amen? Because the Bible lets us know, and I come to tell you this, the Bible lets us know that we wrestle not, in Ephesians, he says, you wrestle not against flesh and blood, but against principalities, against spiritual wickedness in high places, amen? When you're doing something for God, you better have on your whole armor. You better be prepared. Church and vacuum the floor. Vacuuming the floor is no big deal in the house of God. Yeah, I come to tell you, to come in and vacuum that floor every Saturday will be, the devil will come against you with just to vacuum the floor, just to take out the trash, to do it in the house. You can do it all you want on your job. No opposition, no nothing, but to take out the trash in the house of God. I come to tell you, the devil will fight anything you try to do for God. So Paul had to come to his young son in the gospel, and he had to say, whatever's coming up against you, stir up your gift. Amen. Stir up what God has placed in you, because your gifting is not just for the world. Your gifting is for God's kingdom. And the devil never wants God's kingdom to advance. He never, every time you take one step, the devil comes to try to knock you back two steps. And so there's major, major opposition in serving God. And so Paul in this text is saying to young Timothy, stir up your gifting. Have you stopped lately and evaluated your life? Have you stopped lately and evaluated what you said you was going to do for God? What you said you was going to do for God at one time in your life. You said that you were going to serve him faithfully. You said you was going to be committed to him. You said, but all of a sudden, if you evaluate, if you look at your report card, ask yourself, am I doing what God called me to do? Now, some of us, we know what God called us to do. And the enemy will plant excuses in your mind so that you start doubting what God originally called you to do. You know what he said. But to do what he said, you're going to have to go through something. Sometimes you're going to have to tell people no. Sometimes you're going to have to tell people, I can't help you this night because it's Bible study night and I can't help you. I can't help you. No, I know you got a problem, but it's Sunday morning and I have to get to church. I can't let nothing stop me. I'm trying to start this business, amen? And this business will bring glory to God's kingdom. And every time you step out to do something, there's something else. Children need money. Husband don't want to get off the cash, amen? Something is always something coming to try to cause some form of opposition. When you stir up the gift of God, when you work with into your passion. Yes, you can have a desire. Many of us had desires. Many of us all have desires. But I come to tell you, if the devil can take the fuel out of your desire, if he can take the passion out of your desire, you're not going to. Many of us have cars. Amen. But if you don't put no gas in it, see, passion is the gas that gets the Christian moving. Passion for something. How many of you love somebody before? Oh, how many really love somebody? I'm not talking about this nickel dime love, puppy love. I'm talking about that kind of love. Remember Diana Ross wrote that song? She said, ain't no mountain high enough. She said, ain't no valley low enough. She said, ain't no river wide enough to keep me from you. Could you imagine the songwriter who wrote that song? He must have been in love, amen? He said, ain't nothing can stop me from doing what God has called me to do. That's the kind of passion you have to have in your gifting. That's the kind of passion you have to have when you serve God. You have to say, there's nothing that's going to stop me from doing what thus saith the Lord. Amen. There's nothing. I listen to people who say, I want to do this. I want to do that. But how many of you know God will make a way for you if it's His will? If it's God's will, you know when you know something is God's will? When it's not self-centered?
Yes, yes.
That's how you know it's God's will. When you know it's going to bring glory to His kingdom, you know it's God's will. When you know it's going to help somebody else, you know it's God's will. God's will is never self-motivated. God's will is always motivated on serving or helping or pleasing someone else. Amen. See, when we get the passion in our hearts to please God, when we really get that passion deep in our hearts to please God, we will serve others. Timothy in this text. Timothy came from a bloodline of people who loved God. His grandmother served God. His mother, Eunice, served God. So Paul knew his son. He says, I know what you're capable of doing. And sometimes as a pastor, I look at people and I say, I know what you're capable of doing. I know what I see some, you know, Christians have a way of teasing you with their gifts. They'll tease you with their gift. They'll come and say, but Pastor, I just want to show you what I did up. And I want to show you, I want to present to you what I put together. And I look at it and I say, my God, whoa, that's awesome. That's awesome. If I could only get stuff like this on a regular basis. You see? If I can only get, Pastor, let me show you. And somebody get up and they'll sing a song. And I know you can sing. And I'm looking at them like, if they only can do this on a regular basis, I can't do it. I can't do it. But I saw you do it, amen. Even though you were playing around with it, you can do it, amen. Amen. But you see, it's like they stick their foot out and pull it back. They test in the waters, amen. But God is looking for some faithful soldiers.